Hello, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lace and this is a Counterside video. This is going to be kind of like my first impressions. I really gave it a go before I wanted to make this video. And the reason is because I played the CBT, and to be honest, when I played CBT, I wasn't too interested. However, I have given it a way better go this time and I believe that I have a better opinion of this. I think day two of the launch now. I've played many hours now. So it's actually, I hope my opinion is actually worth something now. All right, with that being said, let's jump into this video and let's begin with the whole interface, or what is this all about? So essentially what Counterside is, actually, let me get into an operation so that you guys can see what the combat kind of looks like. Okay, so we have just clicked into one of the maps and let's have it load up, and this is what it looks like. So no, this is not what the combat looks like. This is just like the preparation. You're kind of like navigating the map. Quite a lot of games actually use this kind of system. Blue Archive comes to mind. But essentially what's happening is that I've got a ship or a couple of ships full of people, and I can deploy them and go and attack these monsters. So I'm going to deploy my second ship here. So you can see this ship here, there's already so much opportunity. If you have to customize your ship, you have to upgrade and all that. You guys already know what it is, man. It's another thing to upgrade, and it's pretty cool, to be honest. All right, so I'm just going to deploy a ship here, and then I'm going to deploy another ship over here. So I've got two ships full of 8 people. So I've got 16 people going. I'm just going to start the operation. I'm just going to let it play auto, and it's just going to go and find some monsters to kill. All right, so here we should be getting attacked, and yep, we just got attacked. So this is going to bring us into the combat screen itself. So I'm just going to slow this down a bit and get off auto, and you guys can see what's going on. So I just have to summon units like this, and then they'll go off and do their own thing. So you can see my dude over here, he's just whacking him. My chick over here has got the gun, and then so I've got 3 cost, and this is my mana, I guess. And so this is how much they cost, and then I'm just going to pull this girl out and she is going to heal. So essentially what's happening is that I have a mothership and they also have a mothership, or usually there's a monster on the other side or something. And what happens is that I need to get over to their ship and destroy their ship. It's kind of like battleships, except it's, I guess it is kind of like battleships. And so we have ultimate skills here. You can just click that and then something is going to happen. So he uses Wolvesbane. It looks like it did some damage. So when your units die, they actually come back and you can redeploy them again. So you recognize this dude over here, and it looks like we've actually won here. I wanted to talk a little bit more about the features inside the combat system, the auto battle, auto replay, stuff like that. Let me just get into another battle. So I'm just going to take my truck and I'm going to ran it into this thing. All right, here we go. So I've got my little truck over here. I'm going to summon my boy over here, Kyle. Everybody loves Kyle, my boy. And I'm going to summon a healer, and he is a tank because he throws out a shield. However, our focus is not on the characters over here, so I'm just going to hit auto. And so hopefully it will do things itself. So I just wanted to show you guys what we actually have when we're in combat. So what we have is 2x speed only, which is good. We do have an auto button, which means that we get auto deployment. However, this auto deployment is not really random. I guess it's intelligent, but it's not like it's going to be exactly the same as the previous time I ran it. When you see auto deployment, you kind of think of Arknights, when you finish a stage, you want to save it, and then so you can auto deploy it. What we also have is an ultimate skill. So whenever these ultimates are ready to use, it will get popped off itself. Down here where it says empty, we actually have ship skills. I think my little truck is just not that good yet. So my truck just can't do anything but kill anime protagonists right now. Okay, I'm gonna finish off this round and just turn everything on. And we've also got a repeat operation. Actually, I forgot to show this to you before, but essentially it's kind of similar to Epic 7's repeat operation, where you can oh, I want to do this stage 50 times and burn all your stamina on it. And you would just do something like that. And then so the cost of the 18 stages would be 8,100. And the amount that I have now is 8,500. What we can also do is apply energy saving mode. So if I hit that on, we will go into something like this. And so it's actually playing in the background, and this is, what the frick? All right, and we're back, boys. I'm not exactly sure what happened there, but it was okay. It turned out to be okay, you know? All right, guys, I think that's enough for the battle segment. As you can tell, a bunch of buffs, debuffs, the HP of my ship, the HP of their ship, our location on the field. But yeah, that's a pretty solid summary of the gameplay itself. So let me get into the other systems, because there is actually quite a lot to digest. All right, guys, we are back on the home screen, and I know you guys see that flashing thing. Let's just hide that. Actually, is it going to be back there? Okay, it's still there. All right, so let me just introduce you to kind of the UI and everything that's going on, because there is actually so much in this game. First, you've got your account level over here. I'm level 17. Then you've got your name over here, currency, and your stamina. Interesting, because they use their stamina in oh, look at that. Oh yeah. So as you can see, there's a lot of live 2D, and there's, I think actually almost every character that I've seen so far has been live 2D'd, which is probably one of the best selling points of this game. Actually, if I go into my character box, hopefully you'll be able to see all the characters that I've gotten, and you can see the live 2D of them. It's just a little bit laggy because like I'm running a couple of different things. All right. So as you can see here, Esterosa, she is live 2D'd. And if we go next, my boy, Carl Wong, everybody loves Carl Wong. All of my homies love Carl Wong. I know this ain't a reroll guide, but if you guys are rerolling, reroll for Carl Wong in your 30 selector. And then we got Young Harim. Like, look, it's just so much great live 2D. It's so good. Like, this is like the lowest rarity unit, and even she has live 2D. Like, it's like they just have so much money to throw at this game. Guys, I just want to say, even the ship, I mean, it's not really live 2D, but the ship's moving. In that case, I guess you could call it live 2D as well, but I think you get my point. Like, you know, the art and the live 2D in this game, the production value, it is incredible. Actually, talking about production value, look at that. Look at that menu. It's so fluid. Everything, like, it feels really good to use, right? It's kind of like Arknights, except Arknights, like, you know, when you click something, it takes like 10 years to load. This one, yeah, sometimes that happens too, but like, it is what it is. Also in the operations, so like your story mode, like I'm pretty sure every single stage has a story attached to it, and it's all live 2D as well. So if you notice what just happened before, that load time was like 5 seconds, which is pretty long. I'm not really impressed by that, but it might be just because like my computer's a little bit slow. However, actually on that point, there is another thing to talk about. Right now I am playing on an emulator, but really there is actually a PC client. I'll drop the link to it down in the description below, but I've heard that it is way better experience than playing on emulators. However, if you do want to reroll, you have to do it on the emulator. These guys have made this game quite hard to reroll on. Well, it was hard to find out, but like, it's okay now. All right, so since we're in here anyway, this is where your operations are. This is like where you spend your stamina. We've got the story, you know, it looks pretty clear cut. There is a normal and a hard mode. Got supply operation, so it's just a whole bunch of stuff. Like you guys can already see here, this is like your skill books or like your leveling up stuff. Ship materials to upgrade your ships. This is really interesting. They actually allow you to farm shards and just a whole bunch of like materials and supplies. You guys already know what it is. So next I'll go into simulation. And simulation is kind of the same thing, except it doesn't use stamina and it uses like its own ticket. You get 2 tickets for each of these stages every day, so you have like 6 runs altogether. Next, we've got side stories, and this is really interesting because what you can actually get from these side stories is an SSR hero itself. As you can see here, denoted by this gold border, you can actually pick her up from this freaking stage. So if I click this, this is her shard. However, if I click this, there is actually a chance to get the SSR unit itself. So this one is Orca, and I actually picked it up on one of my earlier accounts, which is like really awesome. I'm pretty sure the percentage is not too high, but like, you know, we freaking take what we can, you know? Obviously it's limited 3 times a day. That's all right. It is what it is. There are definitely going to be more side stories as we go on, but like, that's just what we have right now. But I think it's really cool that like some of the characters, the SSRs, the highest rarity units, actually are able to be like farmed through story. That is most definitely a tick in my book. All right, next we've got counter cases, which is just like your, I guess, like files kind of thing. You can click into them and then you'll be able to read stuff. It's just more story, which is, it's like I said, the production value in this is quite a lot. All right, so I'm just gonna leave the operations now and let's go look at something else. So next, let's have a look at the squad menu and see how exactly this works. So every squad has a ship. So I'm using Truckkun over here. This boy is named Under Control, and all these ships, they all have like their own, I suppose, like attributes. So you can see here, this coffin, which is an assault ship, it can only move these like 8 squares around it. If I go down, you see Normandy. Look at this big boy. He can move so far. And then if I come back here, we've got Truckkun, who can move in like that plus shape. After that, you've got a bunch of units. Like you can just click on them and you can like edit the team. As you can see, there are skills, there are stars. You can see that like there is going to be a dupe system. She is a 3-star natural. She can go up to 6 stars. And let's have a look at the details. All her stats are over here. You got the skills over here. You can enhance the unit. You can level them up, stuff like that. Equips. Oh boy, equips. This is going to be an interesting one because this has a lot of RNG in it. As you can see already, we've got 3 bronze hands and they all kind of have different stats down there. I'm not a big fan of this. It's quite common in gacha games. I'm talking Summoner's War. I'm talking about Epic 7. Just because it's common doesn't mean it's good. I'm not a fan of it, but it doesn't mean it's a game breaker. I mean, if the rest of the game is good, then, you know, I'm happy to stick it out. All right, so that is it. And oh, baby, skins. Let's freaking go. All right, she's got no skins. So that is really sad. All right, next, let's have a look at the recruit, in which we can actually get new characters. Boy, oh boy. boy, I don't know what else I can say. Look at that. Just look at it. So good. So good. There's types for everybody. There's types for everybody. Honestly, the secretary or operations lady is probably one of my favorite characters. All right, since we're here, let's talk about like the earn rate or like the generosity. Starting from yesterday, there were 10 free recruits a day, up to 160 free recruits during the event. That means we're getting a total of 160 free recruits on this banner with all of these lovely ladies on RateUp. Let me show you the rates over here. It is a 3.5% chance for SSR, which is quite good. For reference, you've got like 0.6% for Genshin. You've got like 2% for Arc Knights. However, they all have their own pity systems in place, in which we also have a pity system as well on top of that. So what we do have is a 150 roll pity. It takes 150 of them to guarantee one of the rate up units. You can't guarantee this lovely lady. You cannot guarantee this lovely lady. You can only guarantee that you get one of the two. I don't know how I feel about that. I personally have been burnt many times because of systems like this, but like, you know, it seems quite fair. Considering we get a crazy amount of rolls, like pretty much like everything you do, you can kind of get rolls. All right, let me get into the missions. And it's just, oh man, it's so generous right now. It's freaking crazy. So as you can see here, this is like a new starter mission. And at the end of it, you get an SSR selector. On top of that, when I go into the missions over here, we also have like a whole bunch of stuff here. And you can see a whole bunch of these missions actually give this, which is our rolling currency. We use this ticket to do recruitment. So there's one here, there's another one over here. Like they're just freaking everywhere, to be honest. But yeah, this is your mission. So you guys already know what it is. Dailies, weeklies, achievements, which are in there all the time, emblems, stuff like that. All right, next we've got a world map, which is it's kind of like pretty much your dispatch system. It's nothing really crazy. As you can see, we've got a whole bunch of locations. We just buy out the location, we send someone there, and then we get them to do some work. For example, this one takes 8 hours. He's already been like at it for 5 hours, and we get some reward at the end of it. However, what's not so great about this is that when the units are actually doing their work here, they cannot be used in your attacking squad or whatever. Not a big fan of that, because like Genshin had something similar, and then they realized like, oh man, if you roll all these characters, but you can't even use them because they're on dispatch. Yeah, the system's kind of like whatever. It's not too big of a deal breaker. It's not a deal breaker. It really isn't. It's not a big deal. All right, then we've got HQ, which is where you do a lot of upgrades, because this is a really interesting one, because how you upgrade your units is you go to the CEO's office and you do a salary negotiation. After that, you select a target and then you put somebody in, and then you have this character here, and then you give him a file or something, and then we start our negotiation. So we're going from 46 to 47, and then you see this is us. We are the robot, and we are now negotiating with this character. So what we can do is we can actually like offer more money to gain more stuff, or we can offer less money and not gain like anything. I think as beginners, we should be offering less money, because money is just such a rare currency in this freaking game. Like, holy moly. As you can tell, like this is where you upgrade a lot of stuff. You can upgrade your ships. Like, oh, look, everything is live 2D. The production value is insane in this game. Gear enhancements, crafting, all that, labs, like skill trainings, limit breakings, everything. Everything is in HQ. All right, what do we have left? We have the gauntlet, which is probably one of the most important parts of the game. So essentially this is PvP. We've got ranked battle as well as strategy battle. So strategy battle is essentially like, you're just gonna pick an opponent and then you're gonna auto against them. Whereas ranked battle is actually real-time battle. So like you're paired up against somebody and then you're going to fight them one-on-one in real time. I'll show you guys strategy battle first, but essentially it's just like fighting against a bot. That's really it. So this guy looks like he is going to stomp me, but let's do it anyway. Frick, let's just freaking do it. Let's see what happens. All right, that load screen was very, very long, but let's see what happens. So everything is locked in auto. We can't do anything. Let's see if we win. It looks like I'm doing okay. So I'm up against their ship. I'm slamming it. My ship's back over here is freaking chilling. Oh, okay. So you see this thing over here? This is the ship skill. So I don't know when it used it, but at some point the auto used it. And there's a giant rocket. All right, that's GG. All right, so it looks like there's some like bronze, silver, gold kind of thing. But otherwise, let me show you the ranked battle, which is real-time arena. So you get like this currency every like, I can't remember, it was like 2 hours or 6 hours or something. And so you use that currency to actually fight. So let's just get into a round and see what happens. All right, so this is our team right now. I'm gonna change out my ship for a better one, the Glipnir. Look at that. It's freaking looks like it's out of space, dude. All right, this looks fine. Honestly, I'm not really sure what I'm doing here, but let me just like form the squad. Let me do a deselect and then auto form. And it's exactly what it was before. So I guess that didn't really do anything. Let's close that. And then let's go find an opponent and let's see who we get. Hopefully they're not too good and I don't get stomped. And we are in the game, so... Oh, crap, I forget. I always forget that, like, this... You need to actually, like, turn on auto or something, or you need to do something, because, like, you get into the game, you get into the real-time arena, and auto is always turned off. All right, let's stop the footage there, because, like, if I stop it here, you guys will never find out if I actually won or if I lost. All right, so you guys are not gonna find out whether I won or lost that game before, and that's okay. I still get my reward, so it is what it is. All right, so I'm back here, so let's see what else we have. We have the shop. All right. Oh my God. Like I said, guys, this game is, it's got everything in it. All right. So these are your packs. Like, just take a quick look. This is a 10 roll, I think. Wow. For like $3.81. Actually, I might buy that too. It's very generous. It's quite reasonably priced. So this one is $9.62 AUD, which is probably about like $6 or $7. And you get guaranteed an SSR. Obviously, this is just one of the starter packages, but like, it is what it is. Other than that, however, very standard kind of stuff. Skins. I wanted to show you guys skins. Skins completely live 2D'd. They are so nice. So much effort. Like, you guys can already see, like, there is just like so much production value. I don't think I need to say it again. Like, look at that. Look at that. So as you can see, some of these are going to be bought by different currencies and not the premium currency itself. Other than that, I think you guys already see that's a pretty good look at the shop. Let me see if there's anything else really. Management, which is just the collection of your heroes. You've got mail, you've got community, guilds actually. So there are actually guilds called the consortiums, and I haven't actually joined one yet. So it's actually going to put me through this cutscene. All right, and I'm back. And so as you can see here, you can either join a guild, and so here they are, and you can also create a guild, establish one. When you're in a guild, what you can do is you can actually go into raid battles, and so you just get like rewards as like random bosses pop up. Pretty cool thing, but I haven't joined one yet, so unfortunately I can't show you guys. I'm sorry. Other than that, that's kind of it. Oh, finally, because this footage is very long. But yeah, all right, I guess let me give my thoughts around this game. So I've shown you guys everything. It was a lot, to be honest. When I first played this game in CBT, it was really overwhelming. And honestly, even now as I play, it's still kind of overwhelming. Like, there is so much in like a new game. I think it's okay though. I don't think it's like a negative thing, especially combined with like the generosity so far. Like, I know it doesn't look like I have a lot of rolls or whatever, but I actually spammed a bunch of rolls. 3.5 SSR rates, you know, that's really high in my standards. 150 pity, as long as they're as generous as they have been so far, that is really good. On top of that, the live 2D is incredible. Like, there is just so much live 2D everywhere. The gameplay itself, it's okay. It's more of like, if you're into it or not. If you're into like, you know, the side scrolling kind of thing, deploy your units and then they'll make their way left to right kind of thing. I guess in that regard, you can kind of call this game like a fusion of like Ark Knights and like Epic 7, because they've got like full character models, which is amazing because most games these days don't use full character models, as well as like Clash Royale, for example, because like you're sending units off to destroy the enemy base. Again, I think the art is really nice. All the characters, like, you know, I really like a lot of them. I actually really like Kyle Wong. It's so weird, but I actually like him. The voice acting, you guys didn't get to hear it, but it's like Korean. It's quite nice. It's kind of fresh. Considering I play like a lot of Japanese games, like, I'm quite liking the Korean. It's kind of just like a nice change. But yeah, aside from that, I would give this game like, I would say probably like about an 8 out of 10. 8 out of 10, like, you know, it's so generous. The gameplay is quite decent. It's so high production value. However, me myself, to be honest, that's quite a generous answer because I'm not like 100% into the gameplay. It's quite good. It can be quite fun, but like, I can already see the gear grind. I can already see like the massive time commitments. So there are no skip tickets, but there is like an energy stacking mechanism where you can be like, oh, so in this stage, I want to do this like 5 times. So as you can see over here, we've got stack operations. So I think I need to actually drop a unit first or a squad, and then we can use this. So stack operation, and we can do this. So wow, that's actually really good. So essentially what I'm saying here is that I'm going to consume this, but I'm also going to consume this amount of stamina, and it's just going to give me the reward 19 times. So it's kind of like a skip ticket thing actually, but you still need to clear it once. Honestly, this is a decent compromise. You do have the 3-star stage first, which is okay. Although to be honest, I've been having trouble like clearing these, but yeah, skipping stage is definitely a good thing for me. Like for me, I have like a lot of games that I want to play. This game kind of values that time. And so that's definitely a plus. Another one is the farmable SSRs. Not all of them are farmable, but it looks like some of them are, which is really nice. All in all, again, 8 out of 10. I think it is a solid game. If you guys are into games like Epic 7, then I definitely would consider something like this. But yeah, otherwise, I don't have too much to say about this anymore. So in that case, I'll stop rambling and let's wrap up the video. All right, I've got a secret question, and that is, are you guys playing this game? Are you guys willing to give it a shot? I gave it a shot. I gave it like a solid 2 days, to be honest. I quite like it. If I can get to end game and kind of just like have a low maintenance kind of thing for this, I'll keep playing, but like, we'll see. We'll see. I'm definitely not going to promise that I'm going to make any more Counter-Side videos. Like, I might or I might not. It just depends on how much I like it by the time I get to the end. But honestly, that's enough about me. So you guys tell me like whether you guys are going to give this a shot. And if you've already given it a shot, let me know what you guys think of it. All right, I think that's it. So there is not much left to do except, you know, if you like this video or if you found it kind of helpful or kind of entertaining, consider a like, a sub, a comment, a pin. You guys already know what to do. But otherwise, as always, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.